We have yet another measles update. I'm Dr. Frita. I'm going to tell you about this latest measles surge, and then I'm going to tell you how this measles outbreak is really starting to hit home for me as a physician. This week, things have gone bananas. We have another measles outbreak in South Carolina, and in two of the counties that are affected, they have a very low measles vaccination rate. Surprise, surprise. At any rate, this year we've had over 1,900 cases of measles. That's more cases than we've had in 30 years. And we've also had deaths. Please don't forget, two of the deaths were in school-aged children, unvaccinated. Also, for the people in the county, these outbreaks occurred in schools, these outbreaks occurred in churches. And so that means that the people who were exposed and who are unvaccinated had to be quarantined. And so they have to be quarantined for 21 days because that's how long it takes to know if you're going to get the measles infection. Here's the deal with measles. It's highly contagious. It's the most contagious virus that we have, absolutely. And if you get the measles, it's not necessarily a walk in the park. You can get complications like encephalitis, blindness. You can get otitis media, pneumonia. People pass away from the measles. In the year 2000, we had eradicated the measles, but if these outbreaks keep up, we're going to lose our status. The good news is that if you are vaccinated, two doses of the measles vaccine will give you 97% protection from ever getting the measles. Now let me tell you why this measles outbreak hit home. I was seeing patients in my nephrology clinic yesterday, and so I was seeing an adult patient, and her grandbaby was there with her and her daughter. The grandbaby was so cute, and he was so fat, and he was so chunky, and he had a rash. Now, I looked at the rash, and I was talking to them about what it could be. Okay, could it be eczema? Could it just be from a virus, a viral exanthem? Could it be chickenpox? No, not likely. Could it be measles? Well, the virus, rash rather, was on his neck and a little bit on his stomach, his trunk, on his legs. And that's how the measles rash starts, okay? When I was in training, measles was not even a part of my differential diagnosis. I never had to think about it because it was eradicated. Now I literally had to think about it because guess what? This baby was less than 1 year of age, meaning that even though his mom has him up to date with all the vaccines, it's not time for him to get the measles vaccine yet. So through no fault of his own, he's vulnerable if he's exposed. Was I scared for myself? No. Because not only did I have on a mask, but I've had my shots for the measles vaccine. So I have at least a 97% protection from getting the measles. And you can too, as long as you stay up to date on your vaccines. If you learned something new, please give me a follow.